So Tina, we are through with the interview. Do you have any questions for me? No ma'am, thank you. Now this is what happens in most of the interviews. The interviewees just do not have any question to ask from the recruiter. Guys, watch this video to know what it takes to succeed in an interview. Have you often felt during an interview at loss of words when the interviewer asked you if you have some questions for him? Yes, that happens frequently with us. In fact, as a recruiter, I have interviewed a lot of campus hires and experienced professionals as well. And I have always given them an opportunity to ask any questions from me at the end of the interview. 80% of the times I have received an answer, I don't have any questions. You know, that is a big turn-off for a recruiter. Today, I am going to share with you 7 questions that you can ask the recruiter to know whether the job you've applied for is fit for you or not, and also to create a good impression on the recruiter. Ideally, you should go prepared with these questions, and as per the discussion, you can always mold the questions. It is also advisable that you ask around 2 to 3 such questions, not more than that. So you can pick and choose out of these 7 questions relevant to you and to the context of the interview. Starting with the first question. You can always start by asking, how will a typical day look like for me at the job? Why? Because this question will give you insights on how you will be spending your 7 to 8 hours at the job in case you get selected. Generally, when the interview is going on, it typically revolves around the high-level KRAs and the roles and responsibilities of the job. You do not get into nitty-gritties. However, asking this question will give you more information, in-depth information on how you will be spending your actual time at the work. So it always helps from the interviewee's perspective. The second question that you can ask is, who will be an ideal candidate for this role? Through this question, the interviewer will tell you the skill sets he is looking for that job. And this can be an opportunity for you to highlight the skills that you already have which are matching with the requirements of the job. Always use this question as an opportunity to highlight the skills that you might have missed out during the previous discussion in the interview. Moving on to the third question. The third question can be, could you please tell me about the culture of the organization? Well, culture in itself is a vast, big umbrella that consists of values, people policies, teamwork, and how the organization functions as a unit. So, when the interviewer will be describing about the culture of the organization, it will give you insights on how the organization actually functions, what are its core values, and whether you will be a fit in such atmosphere or not. The fourth question which I recommend asking is asking about the experience of the interviewer with the organization. How has his journey been? You know why? Because this question will help you create a rapport with the interviewer when he will be narrating his own personal experience with the organization. So the interviewer will tell you about his tenure with the organization, how he started, how maybe he has grown over these years into the organization, what kind of development opportunities he looked forward to, and how has been his overall experience with the organization. Now, if you're a good observationist and if you're able to relate with the interviewer's answer, you will be able to comprehend whether you will be able to survive in this organization or not. The fifth question that you can ask is, what kind of growth is the organization looking at in next 5 years? Now, this question will give you a lot of insights on what is the growth strategy for the organization in next 5 years and whether it's an aggressive plan or not. Plus, whether you are able to relate to that kind of growth in the next 5 years or not. Yeah? The sixth question that you can ask is, what kind of training and development opportunities are available within the organization? This will give you a lot of insights on what kind of people policies are there in the organization and whether it is a people-centric organization or not. I have seen it in a lot of startups wherein the focus is entirely on business, numbers, profit, revenues. they generally do not spend a lot on training and development, on upskilling their employees and providing them a good trajectory of growth. Hence, if you are kind of a person who is looking for enhancement of their skills within next 1 to 2 years of taking up that role, then you need to be clear on whether you will be provided with such opportunities from the organization or not. And hence, this question makes a lot of sense. Coming to the seventh and the last question, which can be, what is the career development path charted out for this role within the next 2 to 3 years? You might have joined at Destination A. Every role or profile in the organization has a career development path. So what is that path for your role? It is very important for you to know that, right? You cannot keep on staying at the same designation for the next 2 to 3 years. Hence, it is important to understand, where will you be promoted to? Where will you be in terms of your career after 2 to 3 years of taking up this role? All the questions that I've told you are not to be asked in the same order. Ideally, you can pick and choose 2 to 3 questions relevant to the context of your job interview and evaluate more on the job you have applied for. However, there are few guidelines which are to be followed mandatorily while asking such questions. And what are these guidelines? Avoid asking yes or no questions. We call them closed-ended questions. Do you know why? Because 99% of the times, answer to these questions are already available on Google if you have researched more. The idea here is to create a dialogue with the interviewer so that you both are on the same page when it comes to taking up that role and when it comes to entering a new organization. So always ask open-ended questions. The second guideline which you need to remember is, avoid asking multiple questions. The recruiter might get overwhelmed with so many questions being thrown at him at one point of time, and he might not remember all of these questions as well. So it is a good practice to ask one question at a time. The last and the most important guideline is, avoid asking questions on salary, working hours, number of leaves, vacation time, work from home policy, etc., etc., unless and until it has been initiated by the recruiter himself. So all these are good practices which you must follow during an interview to create that impression and increase your chances of getting selected for the job. I hope you find these questions to be useful, and you will be taking 1 or 2 questions from the set of these 7 questions that I just explained to you when you go for your next interview. If yes, don't forget to share your experience with me by commenting on the video or reaching out to me on my email ID. If you find the video to be useful, don't forget to press the like button and subscribe to the channel. I'll keep on coming back to you with some awesome content which will be useful to you. Till then, bye-bye, take care, and all the best for your interviews.